At the end of this video, I guarantee that you will be able to set yourself up to start losing weight every single week without having to pay for any expensive coaches or any expensive plans. Not saying that those things are bad, those things bring lots of confidence to you and make sure that you have security knowing that you're doing the right thing. But these are the simple principles that most people don't know about because there's so much misinformation about losing fat with all these crazy different fad diets and whatnot. Scientific and non-subjective principles that go into losing fat. This is the same across the board for every single person. This is a subject that you guys suggested on my Snapchat. So if you aren't following me already, make sure that you follow me so that you can be a part of this behind the scenes creative process and give me suggestions and whatnot on videos that you want to see. But without further ado, let's just jump right into it. It is so simple. So check this out. Your body uses calories to do things throughout the day, whether that be things that you're choosing to do, like get up, take the stairs, run around, go do exercise, whatever it is, or if it's just regular processes that every single person's body goes through, beating your heart, keeping your brain thinking, keeping your digestion going, all those different things. All those things play a role into how many calories your body uses per day. The amount of calories that your body uses per day without gaining or losing any weight is called your maintenance or your TDEE, total daily energy expenditure. This is the amount of calories that your body will use without gaining or losing any weight because your body is using exactly the amount of calories that are being ingested. So to give a little visuals, imagine that this line right here is your maintenance. If you eat this amount of calories, your body is not going to gain or lose a pound. Now, if you eat less calories than your maintenance, your body is going to have to still use this amount of calories because that's how many calories you burn per day to do all the things that you do, but you're giving it less calories. Now, what's it going to do for those extra 400 calories that you didn't eat today? It has to take those calories from stores on your body, and those stores are fat, glycogen, and muscle. Now, the most important part is that you know that those extra 400 calories have to be taken from your stores, and generally your body is going to take the calories from fat stores unless you're eating way under what you should be eating. A general guideline is to eat between 200 and 600 calories less than your maintenance, and then check every week and see if you're losing about half a pound to a pound and a half. If you are, then you're perfect. You don't need to adjust anything with the calories that you're ingesting. But if you're not losing enough weight, if you're not losing any weight, then you should drop your calories again by another 200 calories. Do this for another week, see if you lose weight, and then if again you're not losing weight, then drop it for another 200 calories and see if you lose weight then. Very simply, trial and error, continue dropping the calories and testing it out for a week or two, see if you lose weight. If not, then you keep going. And that right there is the principle of how to lose fat or body weight just by eating less calories than your body burns. That is all of anything, that is it. All the diets and stuff just play with that principle, and they, you know, they'll be like all vegetables or everything after 10 o'clock or all meat or whatever the diet idea is, but the ideas all have to abide by that principle. You eat less calories than your body burns, which is its maintenance or its TDEE. Now, naturally, hopefully the question that you ask now is, how do I find my maintenance? How do I find my TDEE, my total daily energy expenditure? Well, it's extremely easy, especially nowadays because we have all this smartphone, all this internet stuff. So just go to Google and punch in TDEE. You'll be able to find a calculator. This is the one that I use. You can check out this one if you like it. And all you have to do is punch in your age, your height, your weight, possibly the amount of exercise that you perform per week and the intensity, maybe your body fat if you do know it. You click calculate, and then it's gonna give you a number. Now, this number that it spits out is not a perfect idea of your maintenance or your TDEE. It's a great rough area to start. So what you do is, if you're trying to lose weight, look up that TDEE like I just told you, take that number, and then subtract 300 calories, 200 to 400 calories less than that maintenance. So let's just go 300 calories. Now, eat that new number that you have that's 300 calories less than your maintenance for a week, and see if you lose weight. If you don't lose weight, then drop it another 200 calories and eat for another week. See if you lose weight. This is the basic, super simple principle of losing body weight. Just check whatever your maintenance is, eat a little bit less, eat a little bit less, eat a little bit less, and then you find your magic number. Now you know that you are in a deficit to set yourself up to continue losing body fat. Now, the next question that you might be asking yourself is, cool, I figured out my maintenance and I figured out the amount of calories that I want to eat to start losing weight every single week. but what do I eat? What are those supposed to be composed of? Carbohydrates, proteins, fats, what is it? As a general good guideline, I would say that 50% of your diet coming from carbs, 30% of your diet coming from protein, and 20% of your diet coming from fat is a great average guideline. Your body needs all those macronutrients to do different processes in your body, from just using energy to do exercises, to controlling your endocrine system, your testosterone, your estrogen, to basic brain function, all sorts of different stuff. So don't ever remove one macronutrient entirely. Your body needs all of these things. That's why they exist. There's all sorts of different outlier diets, and that's kind of where you have to kind of put your subjective thought into what you want to do. What's your sport goal? If you're doing a high endurance athlete type of thing, then you're gonna need more carbs, or whatever it is, you're gonna kind of manipulate your macronutrients as you go. But to be basic with it, 50, 30, 20 is just fine, and you're gonna be able to get the macros that you do need for your actual health while still being able to lose weight. Now, how do you find those macros? Well, luckily, this is another smartphone website type of an idea, so all you have to do is take whatever your maintenance number was, and then that number that you found that you wanted to initially start seeing if you could lose weight with, take that number and put it into a macronutrient calculator. Just punch in macronutrient calculator on Google, and then there's gonna be a box that says calorie amount. You punch in the calorie number that you decided on, that you figured out yourself, and then you can decide the target ranges of the carbs, proteins, and fats. Usually it's set up to be a 50, 30, 20. Again, you can manipulate as you go to see what makes you feel better, what makes you lose fat more, but it's just going to very simply spit out, as soon as you click generate, all the numbers for you based off of the calorie target that you are shooting for, and it's gonna show you the macros that you should be eating for that. Now, is it important to over-obsess with your macros? I don't necessarily think quite as important as some people may make it seem. If you're an athlete, if you're a performance-driven person, then yeah, you're probably gonna wanna keep more of an eye on your target macros. Make sure that you're trying to get them like within a 5 gram range or whatever. But the thing that I'd say most importantly for most people is to get generally the right macros, but focus on the calories. Because if you get the same amount of calories, but you got a little bit more fat this day than that day or whatever, you're still going to lose weight, period. But if you go over calories and you are really, really a lot closer to your macronutrient goal, if you went over calories, you're still going to gain weight. This is why it's really kind of hard for me to give out specific macro ranges for most people, because I don't honestly think that you should be over obsessing on that, especially if you're someone who already has kind of an issue with losing fat or with just sticking to diets in general. Why make it super complicated? Why restrict yourself so heavily and make it all so that you have to count every single number of every single meal, and it discourages you from doing things that you want in life, and then it makes dieting this big negative feedback loop where you just hate what you're doing and you just can't wait until you're done dieting, and then you end up going and binging and overeating, and then you just ruin all the progress you made. Try to make dieting as simple as possible for you while still being effective. That's probably the best advice that I can give you, and if you can make it simple as hell but it still works for you, then that's what you should do. So that is the basics of losing fat and losing weight. Find your maintenance, detract 200 to 300 calories, see if that works for you, take that number over to the macronutrient calculator, find the breakdown of macros that you want to eat, and then see if that works for you. And if it doesn't work for you after a week or two, drop the calories a little bit, reassess, retry, and figure out the golden number that works for you. And this number will always change throughout your life. As you gain and lose weight, your body needs more or less calories just as a maintenance thing every single day to run its processes. So, you know, in 2 years from now, when you've gained a lot of muscle, whatever, you probably will have a higher maintenance. So you'll have to keep retesting this. This is why it's impossible for anybody to say you are definitely needing to eat 2,182 calories. It's all a guessing game that you kind of have to experiment with. Before this video does end, I do want to note that there are going to be areas and situations that you're dieting where you're gonna get kind of sticky and you're gonna maybe not be able to lose weight. You're gonna hit a plateau while you've been able to eat the same amount of calories for 12 weeks or whatever, and then all of a sudden, for some reason, you can't lose any more weight. You drop calories, you still can't lose weight. This is a plateau, and there are many, many strategies that come with dieting that help you not to hit a plateau. But honestly, I wanna make this video a very basic understanding of how to start losing weight. And if you haven't been trying to lose weight for months and months and months and months on end, you probably won't hit a plateau in the beginning. So I wanted to leave those subjects for later videos so that I can go into more detail without making this video like a 35-minute video. I will say though that I have done a reverse dieting video in the past. If you do wanna check out reverse dieting to fix your plateaus or get past your plateaus, I'll leave a link down there, but I will revise that video at some point. I'll redo that video and make it way better, because that video was recorded like many, many years ago, and it's gonna be kind of embarrassing for you guys to watch it, but whatever. So there you have it, my friends, the basic principles of losing weight, losing fat. I hope this video helped you. There is going to be a little bit more of a detailed version of this. I'm gonna be speaking at the Summit Expo on October 1st. If you guys wanna go, I'll leave a link down below as well, but I'll make sure that I have a wireless lapel mic on me if I can do this and record the whole seminar of me explaining all the basics of fat loss and everything like that. So it'll be much more detailed. I'll put that up on the channel for you guys to watch, but I appreciate you guys coming in here. I appreciate you listening to this. I hope that it did help kind of clear things up and kind of simplify things. Maybe now you aren't going to try, you know, the red diet and the evens and odds diet or the all seafood diet or whatever. Maybe now you can just try eating the same regular foods that you know are good and healthy and whatnot, but with a much more strategic and quite possibly more effective version of dieting. That's just the basics and the simple science and truth of it all. I'm done rambling. Make sure you follow me on Snapchat, Brian Turner. Make sure you follow me on Instagram, Thick Solid Tight. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up and a comment. Let me know what you guys thought in the comments below. And subscribe if you're not subscribed already. Team Beyond the Week. CT.
Lift heavy or die, Myron, motherfucker.
Team Beyond the Week. CT.
Lift heavy.